Hey guys, welcome to the day 5 recap of the SciCraft Blitz. We managed to finish some projects yesterday, but I think today's video will be a little bit shorter. There's not too much to show, but let's actually get started. So on the right, we've got a scoreboard right now, and it shows that Sky Rising's second account has 751 levels. So we rebuilt the raid farm a little bit to include a shulker box storage. Let's quickly check it out. So we have the usual raid farm madness going on here. I'm just happy to have a client. Somehow manages to show this. What we actually changed was the chest storage here on the side. So we just had a plain, normal double chest system with item filtering. And this was a bit limiting. After running the farm for 2-3 hours, it was completely filled up. And we actually managed to use up all the gunpowder already again. We had to run the raid farm for another 2 hours. It's a bit annoying. So now we changed to a shulker box system, since we have the shulker farm now, so we can finally run the farm overnight without losing all the items. Let's actually see what we got so far, in terms of, for example, redstone dust. So we got a double chest filled with boxes, and another half one. That's roughly 150k redstone dust. In, yeah, only one double chest, and here's a second one. So, probably a bit over 200k now. Also, gunpowder is always interesting, you need so many rockets. There we got a similar amount, of course, also just witch drops. They all drop the same amount of items, so this is pretty good. Guess we'll keep running this, maybe until the Sky Rising second account reaches level 1000, and then we can actually turn it off for a couple days. Next up, to show you some of the progress I made on the concrete factory yesterday. So this was my project during yesterday's live stream. I was working on this, but it's unfortunately like 99% finished and not quite there yet. It will be shown working tomorrow in the video. But yeah, I can already show you what we're planning here. So concrete factory, like we have in SciCraft or the Peaceful series, that we take the incoming concrete powder and directly convert it into concrete and then blow it up with TNT. We already got this here in the back. So we can collect concrete items directly without having to place them down again. Yeah, pretty much everything is already ready. Probably in 1 hour we could start this up. We still need to assign the item filters at the top. And we actually need to collect every type of concrete powder first. So we need some of the dyes first. Yeah, it's just not quite there yet. But on a day 6 recap, we'll definitely show this working. But I can at least show one finished project, the improved or faster iron farm. Just saw an iron golem spawning there. So we got 14 cells with villagers that are getting scared by a pillager here in the middle. So we're using a pillager because he has the highest scare radius. So with only a single one, we can basically reach up to 7 of the villager cells. And it would spawn the iron golems inside of the portals. So in total, I think we're getting like 5,000 iron ingots per hour with this farm. Let's actually quickly head over to the overworld side. Of course, we have some chunk loading at the top. Again, minecarts that are getting shot through portals. And in the overworld, we just kill the golems and collect the items. Let's fall down here. Yeah, that's where the iron golem is incoming. And it would then just drop down into the lava. Okay, here we go. Got shulker box loaders for the iron ingots. Poppies we don't even collect. We got so much from the other farm already. Yeah. Oh, your new batch just arrived. Actually quite a lot. They said 5,000 iron ingots per hour. Okay, so this has been running for a while. Let's just check it out. Well, it looks like it's a little, but this is definitely a good amount of iron. I wanted to build a larger powder snow farm soon, which just requires an insane amount of cauldrons. So this is actually required for a project like that one. You got one more thing to show, a trident farm. Pricey was working on that. So we need a way to get trident somehow, and it's also really good for Nautilus shells. We also get a little bit of copper, but zombie farm is usually better to get copper. So this was built in a river biome. At the moment we got a lot of people on, so the farm wouldn't work at full efficiency right now. We need to lock people off, and the raid farm is also running. Summons a lot of mobs, but yeah, basically this was built above a river biome. At the bottom we can even still see the river. And it was nicely outlined here. So this was built in a river biome because the drowned mobs have a much higher chance to spawn rivers compared to an ocean biome, for example. So we got drowned spawning in there, slowly gliding down. Then it would land up on the glass platform and see the turtle egg. So they wanna stomp on that. Good old trapdoor trick. It's used again, so they would walk over the edge, fall down, and get put into the bubble column. And then we just got a player sitting at the top that can kill the drowned mobs here. See, maybe we get even a try. I think there was one in there already. See, maybe we're lucky. There was a copper. And I still don't have sweeping edge on my sword. This might take a while. You can also AFK this farm, of course, just need a clicking script and there's a Nautilus shell. Click on the drowned every couple seconds. Okay, didn't get another trident, but yeah, this way it's really easy to get them. Got one more thing to show. Enemy was also playing yesterday. I'm always recording those videos the next day. And you got a brand new hole to show. So at the Mushroom Island biome where we settle in, there's now a 2x2 chunk hole dug down to bedrock. This will be useful in case you want to build a mushroom cow farm. So the farm would be built at the bottom of the hole, and this is beneficial for the spawning algorithm. So the spawning algorithm basically always checks the highest blocks and then tries to spawn mobs between 0 and the highest blocks. In case your highest block is really low, then basically the chance that a block inside of your farm is selected is higher. That's why this is beneficial. Dig out the chunks for a farm. That's why we also, for example, always stick away everything on top of a slime farm. We got over here. That actually has been removed. No, wait. What's going on here? I didn't even notice. It looks like Sky Rising is removing bedrock to make the slime farm more efficient. That's gotta be it. Okay, yeah, he's really going to work here, make a more efficient slime farm. Love it. Okay. It was a nice surprise. Alright, so this is what we got done on day 5. Definitely a plan is to finish the concrete factory soon, and we can already start on like 3 new projects. Memphis has some plans, Alan has some plans, I had some plans as well to maybe work on the powder snow farm, but it might just help Methods and Alan today. Alright, thanks guys for watching. See you tomorrow. Bye bye.